and welcome to SK Med Concept. So today in this video I am discussing about renal clearance by kidney. Actually we have already discussed about excretion part by part. I have mentioned in the beginning of excretion videos that excretion mainly happens through three ways, right? Hepatic metabolism, by urine and by bile. So we have seen about clearance, the equations of clearance, order of kinetics, T half, hepatic extraction ratio, everything is done. And now this is the last part we have to keep in mind about renal clearance. Actually, there is an important clinical importance in this topic. That's why I am emphasizing it. Okay, let's get started with an equation. Net renal excretion is equal to glomerular filtration plus tubular secretion minus tubular reabsorption. So, I know you are very much familiar with this equation because we are studying this in physiology. And even if you have doubts, we will definitely clear it all in the physiology section, okay? Okay, so now, glomerular filtration. So that is the first thing what is happening, right? When the urine is being filtered. So here, in the case of drug elimination, all non-protein bound drugs are being filtered. Because glomerular filtration cannot filter protein bound drugs, okay? That is a very common thing which we know that. Then tubular secretion happens in PCT. And PCT, what important things we have to know is, it doesn't happen simply by itself. It needs some transporters. So what are the transporters? Organic anion transporters and organic cation transporters. So actually these are the two transporters which help in tubular secretion. And tubular reabsorption happens in DCT. Here we already learned that if drugs medium is same, it is absorbed, right? So these are the main points which we already discussed in the previous videos. There isn't nothing much new in these things. But actually what is important is a process known as ion trapping. Ion trapping. This process has a huge clinical evidence, or we can say that huge clinical importance in case of drug poisoning. So whenever a patient comes to hospital with drug poisoning, ion trapping can help us to save the patients. Okay? So what happens here is, if there is a poisoning by weak acid, we can eliminate that weak acid from our body by alkalization of urine. What does it mean? Actually, it means the patient has been affected with a weak acid. We are giving a base in order to excrete the weak acid from our body. And if the patient is affected by a weak base, that means if the poison is by any weak base drug, acidification of urine helps in excreting it out. So this is a very important procedure known as ion trapping. This is done in case of drug poisoning. For example, let's imagine that the patient came with phenytoin poisoning. Okay, so then it is a weak acid. So now we are going to alkalize the urine. So what we will give? We will give bicarbonate. Fine. So when we are giving bicarbonate, alkalization of urine occurs, and what happens? The weak acid is being eliminated from our body. So this is actually known as ion trapping, and this is very efficient in treating drug poisoning. So with this, I'm going to sign off for today, and I'm really happy to say that all our processes regarding pharmacokinetics are done with this. In the previous videos, we have already discussed about absorption, then we came with the distribution, then metabolism, and finally excretion. In excretion, whatever important points to be kept, I have already discussed it all. So this is a pharmacokinetics. It means what body does to drug. So these are the processes what body does to drug. In the next video, we will be discussing about pharmacodynamics. Now we need to know what drug does to body. So that is a totally different topic and subject. Okay. So pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics together makes general pharmacology. So all these things were discussed in the previous videos, and I hope every point up to now is clear. So in next video we'll be discussing about pharmacodynamics, because we need to know what drug does to body. So now we already learned about pharmacokinetics, and I hope it's very much clear, and let's continue with the journey. Thanks.